So today we have with us Dr. Partha Chakraborty. He is ex-director for IIT Kharagpur and currently principal investigator for National Digital Library Project. It's an extremely interesting project and has huge relevance during this COVID-19 crisis. So Partha sir, welcome to the discussion.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to always talk to you, Amit.
So, sir, I would like to ask you a very, very basic questions because large number of our viewers are still not aware about National Digital Library for India. So, what is National Digital Library? What are its capabilities and how they are relevant in this COVID crisis?
Yes, thank you. I think this COVID crisis has shown that the huge amount of efforts that the Ministry of Human Resource Development put in the digital library and in the digital initiatives for education are bearing fruit. So over a period of time in 2014, we found that a lot of digital content is being developed. There are a lot of people who have got sites of material. There are a lot of facilities available to Indian researchers in terms of journals and books and material, but none of them is available in an integrated form to everybody so that they can search under all circumstances. So what National Digital Library, which we called, found out is that if we have to grow this country in the digital platform, then we have to integrate all the education material from KG to PG and put them in a mechanism such that any student can get access. So what we have done over this period of time is now we have a 45 million indexed collection of material which covers everything from books to videos to software to simulation to journals to research papers to thesis. Everything else categorized in terms of class, in terms of user categories, whether it's a class 6 material for magnetism or it is a research material for magnetism, whether it is a NPTEL lecture or a SWAM lecture on magnetism or whether it is an MIT lecture on magnetism. So in everything, students will now get an integrated view. All school boards have provided their text material free of cost. So now every citizen of India through this website and mobile app have access to academic content. This is the national integrator of academic content. And today, we have just yesterday completed 25 lakh active users of National Digital Library. So National Digital Library has come out to be a national integrator, and now from courses to literature to data to a lot of unique things have come up there. So it is the storehouse of academic information available to every citizen of this country free.
Sir, currently there are large number of such platforms in India as well as digitally, because you have a lot of MOOCs platforms, you have even huge amount of material on very basic platforms like YouTube. So what is the USP of National Digital Library over these platforms?
Firstly, is that we are not a competitor to any of these platforms. We are their integrator. So we have all the MOOCs, SWAM, NPTEL, everybody, even now during this COVID crisis, anybody who is developing material is contributing to the National Digital Library. So suppose you want to study computer algorithms. So the National Digital Library, if you search, you will get material from MIT, from SWAM, from Khan Academy, from everything else in one platform. And then if you want to filter it out based on which type of student you want, you can get it filtered. You want CBSE material, you will get it. You want NCERT material, you will get it. You want West Bengal State Board material, you will get it. So it's a single window platform which will provide you with all resources. So we are grateful to all these people for having developed these resources and having collaborated with us so that we can offer this one window view.
When you are talking about material from Khan Academy or from other, so you are also offering material from private organizations which are relevant for competitive exams for JET, for GE or NEET or even UPSC examinations.
Yes, yes. Actually, yesterday itself, I was having a detailed discussion with your AICT, Buddha Chandrasekhar and others about how we can do a two-way linking about all the NEET available material can be cross-linked through the National Digital Library, and all the National Digital Library will go into the NEET and the free platform of AICT. So that is how we are cross-linking with each other, so that all the material can be provided through both the sites in an integrated manner.
Frankly, Partha sir, all academic institutions are under lockdown. Every student, faculties are sitting at home. I think examinations are also going online. Courses are also going online. Many of the research institutes are also not working to their optimal capability. But it's a time to ideate. It's a time to think. But for that, we require large number of research articles. So whether National Digital Library has access to these research articles, research publications like Nature, Science, you know.
Right, right. So let me tell you that, you know, almost all the important journals are available through the National Digital Library, through most of the major publishers. The abstracts and all are all free. And for the other items, there are certain items which are available on national license to everybody. The whole World ebook library is available. And then all the journals which are under subscription under the MHRD's various programs are all available to the institutions. And the important thing is, if a student is not available in the institute, which means they won't have the IP address of their own institute, so they won't be able to access it through their IP address. But if they access it through the National Digital Library, they will get the access, because National Digital Library provides a unique access through the National Digital Library for which permissions have been given. So now anywhere you are, even if you are not in your institution, but your institution has an access, then you will be able to get it. So we are working very closely with InfliBNet, and InfliBNet is helping us enormously in getting this done. Another important thing you have to note, Abhay, is that other than text and material, data is available in NDL, which means that if you want to do research on data, then you can get access to a lot of data for us to be able to, for people to do research and do analysis. Therefore, wherever they can access to cloud computing facilities, which are available under MHRD Badal, or every institute has their cloud facilities. Therefore, access to the servers are available, data is available, literature is available. And I think for people, faculty members to carry out research, students to carry out research, faculty members to prepare courses, they can select available literature, add a little more to it, and prepare their own courses and submit. So we have opened up a call by which we are telling people, prepare your courses and submit to the National Digital Library as you are going online, so that not only your own students, but students from all over the place can benefit from whatever you are doing. So I think this is a time where we can, you know, look back and start new research activities and initiatives. And we will be very happy to run help in all the hackathons with the data, with the software, with the tools that people want to do across the board.
Another important question when it comes to literature and making it available is copyright issues, sir. So how NDL is actually handling these copyright issues, so that if I access some material through NDL, I don't actually infringe on the copyright issues.
Right. So you know, NDL has been driving digital copyrights all over the world. Now, our own digital copyright policy that we have worked out in the aegis of MHRD, this has been recognized by the World Platform of Digital Libraries. So what we are doing is there are certain materials we own, but the others we are only providing links. So people are going to access those links, and the copyright issues of those links are anyway available. Anybody who wants to contribute to the National Digital Library has the option of keeping their own copyright and sharing the link, giving the copyright to us to disseminate, giving the copyright under commons license to use. So there are various options available. So what we have in our store is all these options are there. And once you create new material out of this, you will be able to use it just as you have the rules of the game are there. But I think there is a very well-defined mechanism. This digital copyrights issue is a very complex issue, and this is not even well understood world over. But we are working very closely. Till now, we have had no problems. Wherever we have had problems, difficulties with other people, we have resolved them very quickly. So I think people are getting access to material and resources, and they will get the copyright issues associated with them. If you want to contribute to the National Digital Library, you can tell us what you want to contribute to. You want to give the link, keep your copyright, but allow us to disseminate the abstract at least to everybody else. IEEE has allowed us to disseminate all its abstracts without any problem. So we are allowed to disseminate all the abstracts, but the copyright of the actual material is still owned by them.
And something similar is also with patent database, sir?
Yes, we also have some patent data, but that is all publicly available information. We are not sharing any privately available information.
Another question which many of these institutes which will be listening to this discussion will have is that if they want to contribute, for example, we have about 1,000 plus universities, public and private together, you know, and every university has its own library. And they would also would like to, and they have a lot of digital content nowadays within them. And they would also like to explore whether they can connect with National Digital Library so that their content is widely available to others also. It could be a branding initiative for them, or it could be a philanthropic initiative for them. So in that context, sir, how you will guide these institutions to contribute towards National Digital Library?
Right. So today we have about 20,000 such contributors to the National Digital Library. Every institute who wants to contribute their library resources, that's got two parts. One is the material that the institute owns, like the thesis, reports and all that. The other is the catalog of its library. Whatever is there in the library, the books whose copyright is with the book owner, but at least the catalog. So both of them, these can be shared through what is called the institutional digital repository. And we harvest this. We have a unique mechanism by which every institute can prepare its institutional digital repository, and the National Digital Library harvests it. We are working very closely with InfibNet, who also has the common catalog of books of a large number of universities. And once that is available, you know, everybody will get to know where the closest book they want is it in which library, which thesis is there where, and whatever is publicly available. So I think we have connected a large number of Indian universities, and whatever is remaining, I would encourage them to talk to us. Even if they don't have a site to host their repository, we will host it for them. So we are also offering hosting services, so as to enable smaller and less endowed institutions to host their content into the National Digital Library.
Knowledge is global, and it should have a global footprint. So, sir, only Indian citizens are eligible to use National Digital Library, or it is available to anyone across the globe? This is my first question. The second question is, sir, because now world is a global village, National Digital Library, whether they are collaborating with similar such initiatives worldwide, so that a bigger network of libraries could be actually created, and which will be in general useful to humanity at large.
This has become a very important issue. We are part of the European consortium, where we are collaborating and sharing content with Europeans. We are working very closely with the American Library Congress and the American libraries. We are working with UNESCO to provide library services to SAARC countries, Bangladesh, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, and everybody else. So we, you know, now it has been recognized that the National Digital Library is India's digital academic face. And we are now cross-linking and cross-integrating with the other worldwide libraries. We are part of World Consortium. We are members of several Right Statements consortiums. And we are driving some initiatives and we are participating in others. It has become a very enriching global experience for us.
So Partha sir, as now National Digital Library is linking with multiple international libraries, you must be sourcing content in different international languages, which Indians may not understand, like Spanish, French. So whether National Digital Library is doing any effort to actually translate that content, that's my first question. The other question is that a lot of literature is available in English, which may not be easily understandable, or which our common people at a grassroots level may not easily understand that. So whether any efforts are being done by National Digital Library to translate some of the content for our in our local languages?
This is a very important point that you have stated. Currently, we are able to handle 30-40 languages. So we have search capability in 10 Indian languages, and we are slowly moving to 30 Indian languages. We have in French, Spanish, all the material we have. But the point that you stated is one of our future goals. We currently do not have a mechanism for translating others to Indians and English to Indian languages. And this is a very important thing I have discussed with Dr. Vijay Raghavan also, in terms of being able to provide that multiplicative effort to the Indians, so that you know you can read in your mother tongue. And so the way to do it is has to be a crowdsourced, curated mechanism to do it. A linear approach to get this translation done will not happen. So this is a project that we are working on, and I think I really thank you for you know highlighting this, because this is going to be one of the most important things for us to make such world knowledge available to India is in the Indian local languages. I think this there has been huge research in language translation in India, and we must utilize that information to convert many of these into Indian languages. This is thank you for pointing it out. This is a very important goal.
So Partha sir, we will close down on this very interesting positive note. I hope that large number of students and faculty will use this National Digital Library facility. And currently you have 25 lakh users, but let's hope during this crisis itself, it jumps down to 2.5 crores and large number of students and faculty will get benefited from this national effort, which Ministry of Human Resource Development is trying to do. Thank you, Partha sir. Thank you for talking to us.
Thank you, Abhay. It's always a pleasure talking to you. Thanks for talking about the National Digital Library. Bye. Have a great time.